Hello, investors and traders, and welcome to the weekly market report with the Market Guys. I'm AJ Monty. This is a one-year daily candle chart of the Dow Jones Industrial Average ETF, ticker symbol DIA, and it's not hard to see the dramatic point drop that we had this week with a historic one-day point drop on Monday, followed by a slight dead cat bounce. And then on Thursday, another down day followed by this long shadowed candle right there known as a spinning top. Now, I left this in place so you can see exactly how fan lines work. Remember, from last Friday, I said that we would most likely drop early in the week because this fan line right here was broken. And one of the rules for fan lines is that once a fan line is broken, it generally gravitates back to the next fan line in the sequence. So what you're not seeing here is a fan line from the weekly chart way down at the bottom of the chart. That would be fan line number one. This is fan line number two, three, four, five, and six. So I left the fan lines in there so you can see exactly how it plays out. And it started with the most extreme fan line back here on January 29th. And it broke down below the fan line. It broke down below the fifth fan line, gravitated to the fourth fan line. It broke the fourth fan line, and look what happened. On Friday the 9th, which is the day I'm recording this, the low came within pennies of this fan line, and then we rallied up towards the end of the day. So what does that mean for next week? Well, let me first erase my forecast from last week right there, and I'm going to show you now that we've hit the third fan line, there's a very good chance that the market is going to bounce off of that fan line and actually trade right back up, because this previous fan line right here, which is fan line number four, was at one point support and is now going to act as resistance. So the bounce that we're expecting is going to be driven by investors coming back in, expecting maybe an oversold market at this point with a correction that is long overdue. And I think you're going to find some investors and even some fund managers moving in at these lower levels. Again, keep in mind, if you're thinking about getting back into the Dow Jones Industrial Average and any of those stocks that are included in that average, if you buy, the good thing to do is to put your stops below this fan line, because look right here, we break down below this fan line, then there's a good chance it's going to drop all the way down to the second fan line, which is number two fan line right there. And you want to protect yourself from a downturn if it continues. So that's the diamonds. Now we're going to see the same story play out in the broad-based index, especially with the Russell 2000. See, again, a dramatic drop in the price. Again, historic drops. And we have this long shadow underneath this candle, which tells us that the sellers tried very hard to push the prices lower, but failed to keep them lower as the buyers stormed back in towards the close. So I'm going to erase all of these lines right here. And I'm going to redraw one line, which is going to be the roll reversal resistance right here, because it was formerly support. Now it's broken. It'll turn into resistance. I think that the Russell 2000 will most likely move higher next week to test that as a target price. Moving right along, if you look at the S&P 500 through the spiders, you'll see same thing, same candle, long shadow, spinning top. I did say that the S&P would drop early in the week. It certainly did that. I think there's very few people out there that were able to call a historic sell-off like we saw this week, but the market did fall off, and then we see this candle right here, which means that we're probably going to rally. So all I'm going to do is really erase this line, because I still think we're going to see that rally, and I'm going to draw it down here as we pop back up to recover some of what we've lost. So that's the forecast for the S&P. Now finally, if I go to the Qs, that's the NASDAQ market known as the power shares. Look at that, fan line number one, fan line number two, fan line number three. I said the market would sell off. It did early in the week. It tested fan line number two slightly, and then it broke right back down, moving to fan line number one. So now we're expecting a bounce off of this fan line to go right back up and test the second fan line in this sequence right here. So I'm going to erase this line right there and leave this in place for next week. Now finally, the VIX. This was extremely interesting because the VIX rallied up, and I said it would go up, and then I drew out a two-week forecast. This is more like a 3 to 4 week forecast right here. I said that the VIX would go up and then start to pull back. So I'm going to leave this in place. Remember, the VIX is inversely related to the S&P 500. So if the VIX pulls back like we think it will, then that's going to support the idea of a rally in the S&P, which I've already discussed. Now, if you'd like to learn more about what we do at The Market Guys, just go to themarketguys.com, click on the video link right there, and if you'd like to learn about fan patterns, that's the first video right on the top left of that page, and it'll teach you how to draw the fan lines so that you know how to use them, not just as a forecasting tool like I just did, but more as a risk management tool to protect against the catastrophic loss. So I'd like to thank you for joining us at The Market Guys. Stay tuned, and we'll talk to you later. So long.
This video segment is a small part of what The Market Guys offer through their educational products and services. If you are interested in any of our Trade Alert services, or you would like more information about our one-on-one mentoring program, simply contact us at info@themarketguys.com.